na prestaio budale si mate go piveta cantami Jai Hind, Jai Hind, Krishna. Bokam Vishnu Padaya Gaura Prishthaya Bhutale Shishimat Bhakti Prakyana Kesavaiti Namine Vancha Kalpataru Bhrasya Kripa Sindhu Dhaivacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Nama Namo Mahabhadannaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gaurati Se Nama Gurave Gaurachandraya Radhikaya Itadalaya Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tadabhaktaya Namo Nama Tavaivasmi Tavaivasmi Najima Mityabina Iti Vigyaya Radhe Tangnaya Mama Charna. First of all, my heartly obeisances in the Lord's feet at my Paramaradhyatam spiritual master, Sri Srimad Bhakti Prajnan Kesava Goswami Maharaj. And same in the Lord's feet of my Siksha Guru, Nitya Lila Prasam Vishnu Pada Sata Sri Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. Prem Vibhakta. Once Sri Raghunath Das Goswami asked something to Swarup Damodar, what should be my activities? How should I do bhajan? Ask Mahaprabhu. And then Mahaprabhu told, Gramya katha na sunibe, gramya varta na karibe. You should not tell vishay katha. Bhalo na khaibe, bhalo na paribe. Don't take worthy clothes and tasteful preparations. Amani manat bhaye Krishna naam sadalabe. Giving man to others, giving respect to others, don't hunker for self-respect. And Krishna am always. So these upadesh are for always for you all, not for Raghunath Das Goswami. And this is the answer of all the question you do. Braja Radha Krishna Seva Manushe Karibe. And from taking the procedure of serving Radha Krishna in mind, in heart, and you should do Manushi Seva. Yagya Payarabhu Puchila Tapan, Bujila Tapan, Piriti Nahai Kabu Jode Desata. Then Raghunath Goswami thought that Piriti is not a thing between ladies and men of this world. Manasatya Siddha De Kariya Bhavam Shai Dehe Radha Nathe Karibe Sevam. And then, by taking the procedure from Gurudev, always serving Radha Krishna in mind, in heart. Vikshahena Sahishnuta Apane Karibya. Always be tolerant like trees. They don't live for themselves, they live for others. Their bark, their seeds, their fruits, their shades, their everything is for others. And if They are dying for water. Even they will not ask for you. So be tolerant if you want bhakti. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also said this. Bahya dehe krishnam sarvada sarvakal bhaga. And by this tongue always Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Even in sleeping time also you should do. Antar deha thake raga krishna sevaya. By mind chant, by this tongue chanting Hari name, and in mind, oh, remembering the sweet past tense of Krishna. So, Raghunath Das Goswami has also told, like so, Rupa Goswami, he is Das Goswami, the last essence of all. Tannam Rupa Charitadi Sukritananu Krameena Rasana Manasi Niyojya Tishthan Braje Jananuragi Jananuragi Kalam Ned Khilam Yuttu Kudeshasa. Be situated in Vrindavan. Because Radha and Krishna always in Vrindavan. And by turn, always chanting Radha Govinda, Radha Gopinath, Radha Madan Mohan, Hari Hare Nama, Krishna Jadavaya Nama, Jadavaya Madhavaya Keshavaya Nama, Gopal Govinda Ram Sri Madhusudan, Giridhari Gopinath Madan Mohan, Radhe Jai Jai Madhav Daiti. And is remembering the sweet pastimes of Krishna. If Radha Namoda, then Dambundhan Lila. In this way you should go on doing it. Bhalo khawa bhalo para paritya kari. Don't hanker, don't go after always delicious foods, delicious hotels, delicious clothes, nothing. Only to have anyhow our maintain our life, nothing else. So Rupa Goswami has also. So I think our classes are here. Conference is totally successful. All are happy. Anyhow, good cooking, good arrangement, and good, most of all, good Hari Katha. Best Hari Katha here. So I think that all are happy here. Now we will begin Krishna pastimes. And also I want to give my heartly blessings and thank to manage this huge crowd here, devotees. So for this, Krishna Das and his friend Dharmaraj and party Dharma Das. And so I don't remember their names. Oh, you should know that Srinivas also, my heartly blessings and my thanks to you that you have managed so well. And also my heartly blessings to Sannyasi, Padmanabh Maharaj, Nemi Maharaj, I wanted to finish so many, but we could not we cannot. First of all, how the gopis of neighborhood, motherlyhood, they used to complain to Yashoda Maiya, "Oh Maiya, Krishna is very naughty, and he anyhow with a crowd of boys, and he enters in our rooms and stealing butter, milk and everything. And if not we have stolen away in another place, then he pinching our babies," and they began to cry. Sometimes so many. Then Yashoda Maiya thought that what I prepared
butter.
Oh, it is not so sweet because my servants, maid servants start doing. So today I will milk myself high class of cows, Padma Gandha and others, and I will myself make very sweet yogurt and makhan,
butter.
So he gave up leave all and alone, and she was doing so, and now he was chanting Govinda Dabo Dharmate Ji, Govinda Dabo Dharmate Ji, Govinda Dabo Dharmate Ji, Govinda Dabo Dharmate Ji.
Oh, after that, you should try to tell something.
Haribo.
Achyuta Beta Ki.
5 minutes.
ज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनवाक्य चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः।
First of all, I offer my most respectful obeisance to the lotus feet of my Srila Gurudev, Rupanuga Acharya Vari, Om Vishnu Pada Stotarshat Shri Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. After that, I offer my most respectful obeisance to all the sannyasis, acharyas, and everybody in the audience. So, we have been hearing from Srila Gurudev how Krishna would go to the gopis and he would on the pretext of stealing butter, the gopis would catch him and they say, "What are you doing?" Krishna says, "I'm looking for my calf." And the gopis will ask, "Oh Krishna, where is your calf?" And Krishna will say, "Oh, go into his shirt and pull out a cow." Cow. And he'll run, he'll laugh, and everyone will run away and get away with something better. So one day the gopis had had enough of this, and they decided that when Krishna would come, then they would catch him. So one day, it so happened that Krishna was at one gopi's house, and he was eating butter and feeding to all his friends. And so one gopi caught him red-handed, and she said, "Oh, now I've caught you. Now I will show Mother Yashoda what person you really are." So she took his hand, and she put cloth over him, and she was walking to Mother Yashoda's house. On the way, Krishna told this gopi, "Oh, my hand is hurting, please, can I change my hand?" And the gopi said, "Oh, you want to go away? You want to run away from here?" So then she said, "Oh, okay, give me your hand." And so Krishna gave her hand. Krishna gave his hand. And instead of giving Krishna's other hand, he gave one gopa's hand, one sakha's hand. And he went back to his own house and pretended to sleep. So then, when this gopi was going to Mother Yashoda's house, she said, "Oh, Mother Yashoda, look at your son, what is he doing? I finally caught him stealing butter." And so Mother Yashoda came out and she said, "What are you talking about? Krishna is sleeping in his bed." So then she said, "Look, here is Krishna." And she lifted the cloth that was covering, and instead of Krishna, was her own son. And Krishna was saying, "See what they say about me? They just tell lies. They just say that, oh, I go and steal butter. So now they won't be lying anymore. I will go to their house and I will steal butter myself." So then Mother Yashoda was thinking, "Oh, my butter, my makhan is not good enough for Krishna. What should I do?" So actually that day she decided to make makhan for Krishna by her own hand. And that day was Deepavali day in Kartik month. So then how was it that Mother Yashoda was able to, by her own hand, make butter for Krishna? Actually, they were preparing for the yajna for Indradev. So all of these servants went back to their own house, and Mother Yashoda was there attending to all the duties. So by her own hand, she previously had made yogurt the day before from the Nanda's most best cow, Padmagandha. Padmagandha is a cow that it is fed on the most tasty grass, the most fragrant, the most best quality of grass. And so,
thank you.
Very good. So we've heard from the lotus lips of Srila Gurudev and Vaishnavas how very early in the morning on Deepavali day, Mother Yashoda, she took the yogurt that had been prepared from the milk of the cow called Padmagandha. Because the milk of this cow has the fragrance, the Ganda of Padma, of lotus flowers. How sweet this milk is. So Mother Yashoda, she took a churning stick and held the ropes, and she was churning. And as she was churning, she was remembering the sweet pastimes of her son, Sri Krishna. And she was singing his name. Tears falling from her eyes, with heart melting, hairs standing on end. She's so beautiful. Very narrow waist and fine silk cloth. This silk cloth is so fine that if you fold it over 10 times, it will still fit underneath your fingernail. And so from this very fine cloth, the beauty of Mother Yashoda was peeping out. Her hair was decorated with flowers, and the flowers were falling from her hair, and she was chanting the names of Sri Krishna. Govinda Dhamodara Madhaveti, Govinda. See, Krishna was had been sleeping on the bed of Madhya Yashoda. When she got up from her bed, she took the hand of Krishna and put his hand on the pillow. So he was lying there sleeping, thinking his mother was there. So when he began to wake up, he was feeling, and then he realized, ah, it's not my mother, it's a pillow. He thought, oh, I want my mother. So then, he's about 2.5 years old, very small, quite naked. He tried to get off the bed. So, he's very small, so he came off the bed backwards like this on his stomach and down to the ground. Then, he was calling his mother, Maya! But no reply. So then he called louder, you know, like you see, Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Da Ni Sa. So he was calling, Maya! 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 Louder and louder. But no reply. Why? Because Yashoda Maya was completely absorbed in the kirtan and smaran, remembrance of Sri Krishna's pastimes. She did not hear. She had avesh, complete absorption in remembering Sri Krishna. So Krishna came out from the room, rubbing his eyes. Madhya Yashoda put kajal back on his eyes. And his tears were coming down and washing the black kajal and making a black stream here. And this eye, kajal was already wiped off. And white stream here, like Ganga, Jamuna, flowing. And running down, and meeting in Triveni, of his navel. And Krishna came out to the place where Madhya Yashoda was churning the butter. And he put one hand on the stick, and one hand on the veil of Madhya Yashoda, and caught her. And when she was caught by Krishna, suddenly she noticed, oh, my son is here. She became overjoyed. And she stopped churning and picked up baby Krishna in her arms and gave her breast milk. Oh, at that time, oh, many, many sattvic bhavs came and milk was flowing from her breasts. And in this way, bhakti became mixed with her sthayi bhav, became mixed with vibhav, sattvika bhav, anubhav, vyabhachari bhav, and it became bhakti rasa. So Krishna was very happily drinking the breast milk. The Vatsalya Bhava of Madhya Yashoda, parental mood. But Madhya Yashoda noticed that there in the kitchen, there was a big pot of milk that was being boiled, and the milk was about to boil over. Why? Because the milk was thinking, oh, Krishna's belly is unlimited, all the universes are in there. And Madhya Yashoda's breast milk, that means her parental love, is endless, more than Kheer Sagar, the ocean of milk. So Krishna, his appetite will never be finished and her breast milk will never be finished. So I, the pot of milk, I will never get the chance to serve Krishna. So if I have no chance to serve Krishna, then no need to stay alive. Like Srila Narottam Das Thakur, he said, Keno vai achaye prana kisuka lagiya Narottam Das keno Nagelo Moriya. How unfortunate I am that I have no opportunity. I am not qualified to serve Sri Krishna. So what kind of happiness will I experience in this life? Nothing at all. Why did I not die long ago? So lamenting his disqualification, the milk wanted to commit suicide and was jumping out of the pot and into the fire. So when Madhya Yashoda saw this, she wanted to stop the milk from boiling over. So she took Sri Krishna and she wanted to put him down. So we heard yesterday from Srila Gurudev how Putana, she had the strength of 10,000 elephants. And Putana, she tried to put Krishna down from her breast. But she tried again and again, she could not put him down. That was when Krishna was only 6 days old. But now Krishna is 2.5. He's much stronger. And he's holding on to Madhya Yashoda with both hands, with both legs, and with his mouth. And with his full power, he's trying to hold on to her. But Madhya Yashoda, just with her left hand, sit up, Paitam, sit down. Easily put him down. Because she's completely controlled him by her love. In the arms of Madhya Shoda, the Supreme Personality of Godhead has become a helpless child. So she got up and she went to save the milk. She sprinkled some water on the milk and it stopped boiling over. Oh, this is because Madhya Shoda is very merciful. She thought that from my best breast milk, I cannot make the paneer, I cannot make rubbery and so many other nice preparations for Krishna. So I should save the milk. Just like Srila Gurudev, all day he can be absorbed in serving Radha Krishna in their Astakalya Lila, deeply meditating and serving them by his Siddhideya spiritual form. But putting aside his service, he comes running to save us. We have no chance or opportunity to serve Krishna. So in this way, Madhya Yashoda was like a guru, giving up her direct service to Krishna to engage someone else. So when Krishna was put down on the ground, he was very angry. He said, I have not satisfied yet. I have not finished drinking. Oh, I should teach her a lesson that she should not put me down again like this. So Krishna, he took a pestle for grinding spices. And the big pot of yogurt that Madhya Yashoda was churning, at the top the pot was thick, but at the bottom it was thinner. So Krishna, he got the pestle and he threw it. And it made a hole in the bottom of the pot. So the pot was full. So if you make a small hole in the bottom, what happens? All the yogurt comes spraying out. So Krishna was watching. Beautiful white yogurt everywhere, spraying all over the kitchen. He was overjoyed. But then he thought, oh no, when mother comes back, then she'll punish me. I'll be in trouble. So if a thief or a criminal does a crime, then they stealthily leave the scene of the crime. So Krishna, he quickly ran away. After some time, Madhya Yashoda came back and saw the broken pot and saw the yogurt all over the floor. So just as a policeman can catch a thief by finding some clues, Madhya Yashoda thought, oh, where's my boy? And then she looked and she noticed something. Even though Krishna, his Supreme Personality of Godhead, he's omniscient, he knows everything. But in Vrindavan, he's like a child. Oh, completely forgetful of his Bhagavata. So he did not notice that when he was leaving, he walked through the yogurt and left a trail of yogurt footprints to the place where he was hiding. So Madhya Yashoda saw the footprints of Krishna and began to follow them. So she came to the room where he was hiding and looked inside. What was he, Krishna, doing? He'd climbed on top of a grinding mortar and he reached up and took butter and he began to feed this butter to crows and to monkeys. He thought, oh, in my previous incarnation as Lord Ram, at that time, many monkeys, they assisted me in the invasion of Lanka to get back Sita. But at that time, I could not feed them, I could not take care of them. So now I will do it. So Krishna was feeding all the monkeys. And he thought the crows, they're in the dynasty of Kakabushandi, who also helped me. So he was feeding the crows. Just then, Madhya Yashoda thought, I'll catch him. And she took a stick in her hand, and she began to sneak up on Krishna because he was facing the other way, from behind. So just like a cat can walk even on dry leaves without making a sound, Madhya Yashoda was walking like a cat, very gently, no sound at all, with the stick in her hand. And she was just about to catch Krishna. When Krishna saw, the monkeys were running and crows were running. He said, why are you leaving? Why are you leaving? Then he realized, uh-oh, someone's behind me. And just as Madhya Yashoda was to catch him, he jumped down and ran. So Madhya Yashoda began to run, but Krishna was very tricky. He went in a zigzag way, so she couldn't catch him. And then Krishna went to the door that leads outside. Krishna was thinking, my mother is very chaste and shy Vedic lady. So she will not go out into the road unless she is fully decorated with sari, ornaments and everything. So Krishna thought, if I run outside, my mother will not catch me. So he ran outside. Madhya Yashoda came to the door, then she looked around and made sure that no one was on the street there, and then also she ran after him. So as she was running after him, She said, "Hey, you! You're a chor! You are a thief!" Krishna said, "I am a chor. I think that in the dynasty of my father, there is no chor. But in your dynasty, there may be a chor." Because Krishna, he heard his parents discussing that one of the ancestors of Madhya Yashoda, his name was Chor Ghosh. So when she said, "You are a chor, a thief," he said, "I am not a chor. In your dynasty, there's a chor, not in my father's dynasty." So he was very cheeky. She said, "Oh, you are Bandar Bandhu, you are a friend of the monkeys." And she asked him, "Who has broken the pot of butter?" Krishna said, "He who creates the pot has broken the pot." This is very deep Siddhanta philosophical point to be coming from the lips of a small baby. So Krishna was running. Then Madhya Yashoda, she took the stick and she went like this, as if she were about to throw the stick at Krishna. So Krishna flinched and covered his face. And then with her left hand, she took the right hand of Krishna and held up the stick. So Krishna thought his mother would beat him. So he ran around behind her legs, like this, going this side and that side. "Oh, mother, mother, don't beat me." So now Krishna was afraid, breathing deeply, tears coming from his eyes, trembling in fear. Even though Apana samsitim goram yanna vag viva sogrinam tatasa jyogi mucheta yad vibeti swayam bayam. The living beings are entangled in the complicated mesh of birth and death, can be freed immediately simply by chanting, inattentively chanting the name of Krishna once, because the name of Krishna is feared by fear personified. But now that very Krishna is afraid of his mother. So Madhya Yashoda, seeing the fear in his eyes, she thought, "Oh, what shall I do? I cannot make him become too much afraid, because if he becomes very fearful and traumatized, then he may become maladjusted when he grows up." So she put down the stick. She didn't want to beat him. But she thought, "I must give him some punishment, because if I don't punish him, then he'll become naughty and naughty, and when he's grown up, he may be a dacoit." So she thought, that grinding mortar that he was standing on was his accomplice in his crime. So the two of them should be punished together. So Madhya Yashoda, she took Krishna and she took a rope and she wanted to tie him to the grinding mortar.
पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। सो व्हेन मदर जसोदा गॉट कृष्ण एंड वांट टू बाइंड हिम, मदर जसोदा थॉट, ओ कृष्ण स्टोलन बटर एंड वाज फीडिंग द मंकीज एंड क्रोस स्टैंडिंग अप ऑन दैट grinder mortar, so both are same type of guilty. So I will bind them together. As before you have heard, if Mother Yashoda not punish him, he may run away, may jump in the Jamuna, or may enter in the forest, there will be big problem. Because of Mother Yashoda got this child in his elderly age, so Krishna is most affectionate to her. So if I not bind him, then how I can do my household work? Because he got given leave, the all maid servants and servants. So he took his silken robe from her bread. And he brought the Gandhar mortar on to bind Krishna. But it became two finger too short. But Krishna quite naked. He has golden waist belt. It's still there. Only 12 fingers, Krishna's waist. Mother Yashoda thought, how come I could not bind this to Krishna? Then he asked other gopis, bring more rope. The Mother Yashoda has so many ropes. One after another, he met in knot and became longer and longer, but always two fingers too short. Gopis telling, oh Yashoda, Brahma did not keep any binding in his fate, in his destiny. Give him up. He said, no, he is my own son. I will bind him today, tomorrow, day after tomorrow, years, birth after birth, I must bind him. Mother Yashoda promised I must bind him. And Krishna thought, oh my goodness, if mother will bind me, how I can go out for play? And all are waiting for me, all sakhis want to take my darshan. When Krishna thought this, then Krishna's inconceivable potency appeared there. So always two fingers too short, could not bind Mother Yashoda to Krishna. What to do? Then Krishna, Yashoda told, oh my sakhis, bring rope from your own house. Sakhis not easily to bring that rope. They are bringing and giving to Yashoda, let take rope. And yet always two fingers too short. Then Yashoda thought, oh my goodness, what shall I do? If I not bind my own son, how I can show my face to all sakhis? What they will think? What they will tell me? That by her mind, he surrendered to her own Kuladevata, Narayan. And when he surrendered to Kuladevata, her Kuladevata, Narayan, what happened? Drishta Parishramam Krishna Kripaya Asit Sabandhane. As soon as Mother Yashoda surrendered herself completely, then her Kripa Shakti appeared there and inconceivable potency disappeared from there. Then Mother Yashoda, from her own bread, the silken robe, he tied Krishna and grinder mortar both. Why so? Why the two fingers too short? We are doing sadhan bhajan. If we think, oh, when Krishna's mercy will come, we will see nothing to do sadhan bhajan. And somebody, no, I will do my own effort, no need Krishna's mercy. Both are wrong. Both are needed. We have to do our own sadhan and have to pray for Krishna's mercy. When two will be together, then you can bind Krishna like Mother Yashoda bind Krishna. Then Mother Yashoda bind him, and Krishna Sakhas also there. Krishna told, Yashoda told, oh my dear boys, please take care of him. And Yashoda went to do his household job. At that time, Baladev Prabhu was not there. That very day was Baladev Prabhu's birth constellation. So Baladev Prabhu, along with Mother Rohini, went to Upananda Prabhu's house, the elder brother of Nanda Maharaj. Then all Sakhas and Mother Yashoda went away inside. Sakhas told, oh Kanhaiya, now, very good. Will you still battle anymore again? Today Mother give you a good punishment. Krishna laughing, joking, they are tickling each other. And now they are pulling. And now Baladev Prabhu came from Upananda Prabhu's house. When Baladev Prabhu saw that Krishna is binding his grinder mortar, he became very furious. Who bind my brother? Madhumangal told, whispering, Maya, Maya. As soon as he heard Maya, then his all anger cooled down. Then also asked Krishna told, okay, let us go outside. We cannot play here. So Krishna told, I am pulling, you can push. So all sakhas pushing the mortar and Krishna pulling the mortar. In the meantime, when they came in the courtyard, then there is a two tree of Arjun, two in tree, Jamal Arjun. They are cursed by Narad Rishi. The two Jamal Arjun tree, they were the son of Nalkubar and Manikri. Once Narad Rishi was passing through, the Nalkubar and Manikri, they are playing with heavenly damsels.
completely naked. But the heavenly damsels, seeing Naradesi, they covered themselves nicely and did pranam from behind the tree. And the two boys, they became very angry. Oh, friendly person, they went to other way to go. Why you came this way? And go, oh, why are you going out of water? Come here, we'll play. Naradesi told, oh, you are son of Kube. You are so much intoxicated. You are treating like a tree. You are like a nut, so you must be tree. When Naradesi touched it, then they feel they became gradually inert. Their consciousness going to be down. Then the full thought of his lotus feet. Naradesi told, what I told, it must happen. But in the upper yug, Krishna will incur in this world and he will deliver both of you. The teachings behind this, Srimad Bhagavat told Sri Sukadeva Goswami, Janmai Saraja Sruta, Sri Vyeda Mana Madhapuman, Naivarhatta Vidhatum Boitamakinchana Gocharam. If somebody took birth in aristocrat family, if someone has too much opulence, if someone has a learned scholar, intellectual giant, and someone is very handsome, by this, they become so intoxicated, very hard for do bhajan to them. Especially, if somebody has so much opulence, then other will come out of other opulences, other three come automatically. So, Krishna remember, oh, my devotee has cursed them, I have to deliver them. Satya vidhatu vinaya vikta bhasitam. What his devotee told, he must make it true. So when it entangled, then Krishna told Sakaso, you can go away, let me try. Then Krishna pulled it so strong, the both sides of the Jamalarjun make a tremendous sound and uprooted both sides, not straight. If it will both straight, then Krishna and Sakha may be crushed down. So hearing this tremendous sound, all Praj became shaking. What happened? Nanda Baba was on far away from there, about Jamuna Ghat. Then he came out from there hearing the sound. All Brajavasis, they are following sound and coming that side. Nanda Baba came and saw, oh, my Lala is under this tree. Up to now, Krishna was smiling and joking and sarcas. As soon as he seen his father and began to weep, began to weep very bitterly. Why? If there is two boys or children, they fight each other, but they are okay. But when they saw their own guardian, they began to weep. Why? Because they want to show their sympathy. Because if the parents will show their sympathy, then they notice him. Then Nanda Baba came. Sorry, prior to that, all Sakhas want to untie Krishna. Subal, Madhu Mangal, one want to untie, and the, you could not do so. Oh, let me do. Then Subal came, then Madhu Mangal, oh, you cannot do so, I will do. By this way, pushing each other, cannot do. Why? Because this binding is not made by Vatsala Ras. So Sakras could not open it, untie it. Maybe Vatsala Ras or Madhu Ras surely. So Nanda Baba came and untie it and give one laddu. In Braj called Gurdhani, make laddu with roasted wheat and good. Krishna holding in his hand, but not eating, only weeping and weeping. Then Nanda Baba took him on his lap and took Baladev Prabhu also. And Nanda Baba told, who bind you? They told, Maiya. Shall I beat your Maiya? Yashoda was not there. Krishna hold his hand. No. So Yashoda Maiya, little far away. She's watching. And all other Prajavasis watching this scene. Nanda Baba became very great to Krishna and Baladev and went to Kaushal. And he gives some sweet candy and milk directly in the mouth of Krishna and Baladev. They took full stomach. They became very happy. And Krishna with father and Dhaubhaiya, then it became about late afternoon. Then Rohini Maiya and others, wife of Upananda, Abhinanda, Sunanda, Tungi, Pibara, Atula, Kubala, all came. and they are telling, oh Krishna, you'll not go to your mother. Krishna told, never. To whom you play, Dau Bhaiya, Baba, will not go to your mother. If your mother passed away, as soon as Krishna heard this, began to weep, Maya, Maya, Maya. And Mother Yashoda was completely like a statue. Mother Rohini took Krishna and put Krishna down in the lap of Mother Yashoda. As soon as Mother Yashoda got touch of Krishna, began to weep so bitterly. All prajas weeping. Rudantam muhurnatram jugmang rijantam. Krishna weeping, Mother Yashoda weeping, Nanda Baba, Baladatu, all prajas weeping bitterly. What to do now? Mother Rohini cooked something very quick and served to Nanda Baba and Krishna Baladatu, all of them. Then Nanda Baba told Krishna, oh, bring your mother, because she has not taken anything yet. Yashoda, a little fearful and not coming, and told Krishna, Krishna pulling her. Yashoda told, okay, your father can take, all of you can, I will take later. After Nanda Baba, Krishna Baladev took prasad, then Mother Yashoda, Rohini and others took prasad. By this way, Krishna renewed his frame for Prajavasis. When Krishna's prem towards Krishna prem of Brajavasi going down, then something happened, then the prem renewal again. When Sriman Mahaprabhu went for preaching South India, then somebody asked this question. In South India there is two logic, one kitten logic, another monkey logic. The kitten, the mother cat, will take her kitten different places. Only baby cat meow, meow, they will not do any effort. And mother will, by her mouth, move here and there. Other hand, the baby monkey, they hold mother very tightly. Mother monkey will jump from one tree to another tree, one root to another root, but baby monkey will hold very tightly. If he drop down from mother's lap, they never touch him anymore. So they ask Mahaprabhu, which one is correct? One called Varangalai and Tilangalai. So Mahaprabhu told, both of them is combined then perfect, otherwise not. Mahaprabhu gave example, just like someone drop into the oil and is cried out, save me, save me, save me. Some person mercifully put one rope and told, hold it. Unless until you not hold it, how can pull you out? The same way, the kitten logic and monkey logic both combined, then it will be perfect. So we have to, what are teaching behind this? We have to do our own sadhana and have to pray. If we do so, then one day we can mask find Krishna like Mother Yashoda. Or other way, who is more advanced, like Sakhis find Damodar with Radhika Radha Damodar, we can find them also like this way. Hare Krishna. Pancha kalpata rupascha kripa sindhu prayavacha patitanam pavana bhuvasa vibhuvanam.